What up, guys? It's Musical Leaders here today, and I'm back with another video. Now, today's video, we're going to react to a Black Veil Brides song called Savior from their album Set the World on Fire. I know the last song from one of my subscribers, Alejandro. He explained to me that Rebel Love Song actually had a music video, so sorry for that. I don't know if I should check that out, you know, towards the end of this album before I do my album review. If you guys want me to check out, you know, the music video for Rebel Love Song, I will do it. But for right now, I already listened to the song, so I don't feel like it'll be too big of a, you know, problem. I could probably just watch the music video on my own, but if you guys really want me to react to it again, but just with the music video this time, I'll definitely do that if you guys want it. So yeah, let's get into Savior. I don't think Savior has a music video. He did explain that Legacy, or The Legacy, which is the next song, does have a music video, so I'll definitely check it out for the next one. But I don't know if any of the other songs have a music video on it, so yeah. Well, this one doesn't, so it shouldn't be too big of a problem. And I do remember we listened to Savior 2 a while back when we were first getting into, when I was first getting to Black Veil Brides and, you know, Andy Biersack, and I was getting to his music. I reacted to Savior 2, which I liked, and I was like, well, is there a Savior 1 or is it just a name thing? So apparently there is a Savior 1, and that was from their second album. So this was long ago. So yeah, this is going to be crazy to see, you know, going from this one to the next one. After I listen to this one, I'll probably listen to the second one again to hear, you know, if there's any, connections to them, like about any themes or stuff, or to hear at least what's the difference between both the songs. So yeah, let's get into it. Okay, so we're like almost halfway through the song. This song is quite different. It's quite interesting. So it starts off with an acoustic guitar and electric guitar, you know, simultaneously, which I think that's pretty cool. I like both styles. It depends on which type of song, you know. Some people like acoustic more, some people like electric more. I think both are great. It just works for different types of styles and different type of, vibes for a song. And both can work very well separately and can meld in together very well. Definitely showcasing in this song. This song also is completely different than the other ones. I did state in the other one that a lot of their songs on this album, they start off really strong right in the beginning, and then they just go throughout the entire song like that. And I usually like songs that are slower in the beginning and then start up and build into the heaviness. But this song, I don't think there's going to be any heaviness in it. When I heard the soft part, I thought they were going to be building up, but seeing the way it is, I don't think that that's what the song is meant to be like. It's supposed to be a lot different, and I'm really enjoying it. I like the change, like I said. I always love when, you know, artists, when they have an album, and the songs have different styles and different vibes to it and different, levels of creativity. They're not the same, all the same. Even if there's a song that might do something different and I don't like it, I can at least still commend them for doing something different. And luckily, I really like this one. It sounds very nice. It does kind of remind me of the Mortician's Daughter and the first album, where, you know, he had a bunch of songs in a certain way, but that one was like completely different and it was more somber. And I feel like the same way for this one. This one seems definitely more holy and stuff, and he was singing a nice, smooth voice, and then when he leveled it up higher, that's what I love. That's what I love to see. You know, artists having some beautiful, clean vocals and melodies, and then putting more power and passion to a single part or a part of the song, and elevating it. So you're making it go into a smooth, beautiful way, and then you're making it go up higher in a powerful way, and then making it go back down. I think that's a very creative and very well way to, you know, sing. And it showcases your vocal range. And he's showcased some very great vocal ranges in this song. And that part really blew me away. And the singing is just very beautiful. It's very well put together. His voice in this one is really great. My favorite song on this album was Set the World on Fire. But this one might be my favorite song on this album. I'm just really liking it. I'm really loving his voice, what he's doing with it. It is just very powerful and it's very moving. And I can't wait to listen to the rest of the song, because this song right now is just so great. And I can't wait to listen to it more times for, you know, my album review, because I think this is definitely going to be my favorite one out of the album. Though there is still quite a bit of other songs from this album I have to check out. But for right now, I'll definitely say Savior is my favorite. It makes sense why they made a part 2, and that part 2 did very well. So yeah, let's get back into it. Spin and teach you how to live what is left unsaid. The greatest gift I give. So that was Savior by Black Veil Brides, an amazing song, quite unique, different than the other songs. The first half and the second half are quite different. The first half had, like, you know, an acoustic guitar, an electric guitar, smooth singing, a little bit of, like, you know, accelerating. I don't know how to say it. I'll just say accelerating, you know, his vocals. You know, his vocal range went up higher and it was, like, very powerful. But then towards the ending, you know, the violin came in. And he started doing more, like, you know, metal screams in it, where we saw a lot in his original album, his first album. And it did remind me of early 2000s rock music, which I liked. Though I don't know if it melded very well with this song in particular. Those work for some songs, but not always. It did work at first, but I think towards, like, you know, I don't know if I would have gone with the idea of using that screaming, you know, vocals throughout the entire rest of the song. I would have just done it maybe a little bit in the song towards the end, but throughout the rest, I don't know about that. I'll definitely have to listen to it more, but I really like this song. I like the difference of, you know, they did with this. I like how unique it was, and I do like how towards the ending it did change up the sound of the song itself. The song is quite interesting, and I really like it. It's definitely more of a holier song, you know, talking more about, you know, saving people, being there for them, and, you know, just waiting there to, you know, help them out. So yeah, I think that's pretty cool to hear, and I can't wait to see the rest of the songs on this album. I'm trying to check how many songs are left. I don't think there's that many.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, like around like 5 songs in this album left. So yeah, I'm pretty close to finishing this. This album is pretty cool. I like the, you know, what they did with it. And you can definitely see this is a step up from their first album. And I just want to see more and more of them, you know, just upgrading and leveling up as artists. Especially as Andy. I love seeing Andy, you know, progress with his vocals and what he can do and his vocal talent. Because he did have a lot of great raw talent when, you know, the first album. The only thing is he didn't tap into the potential enough, and I don't think he had the technique, his vocal techniques down perfectly. But now in this album, you can now see he has significant improvement on his vocals, and this is just a good sign to come for the future, because that just showcases his progression throughout the future songs, especially in his Andy Black, you know, project. What he was doing, his voice, you could definitely tell that he is, you know, he found his real voice and got comfortable with it and knows what type of style, you know, of singing he does. So yeah, I really appreciate that. I think that's really great. This is a fun song. I can't wait to check out the next one, and I will definitely check out the music video. So don't worry about that, guys. I'll check it out, and see you guys next time.